Tonight, Vern Barton tries for his second tee to the complete fisherman's outfit. And you, right at home, can win our complete prize wonderland, including a luxurious box stove and $500 in cash and many more fabulous prizes on 7 Tees. And here's our happy host, Jack Narz.
Here he is. Thank you. And may we thank our studio audience so much for coming down tonight. We appreciate your company, and you at home, we appreciate your company too. Thank you so much for tuning us in. We hope that you will enjoy tonight's show. And this being Friday, that means we'll have the last drawing this week for that complete prize wonderland, the Fox Stole, and the $500. Let's hope tonight somebody wins it. More about that later on. Right now, here's the gent who's back to try to win his second key. Little short fella over here, Mr. Vern Barton. Say hello to him. Stand up! Now, those of you in the studio audience, now that you see him in person, you can believe it. This is one of the biggest guys I have ever seen. Vern is 6'9" and weighs 250 pounds. We've talked a lot about him, learned that he's, actually, you're not employed at the moment, are you, Vern?
No,
you,
I'm not employed.
Happened over the past couple of days?
Well, I've had a couple of offers to put a plug in, but that doesn't give me the actual job, so I sort of passed that by.
Vern was a salesman. And believe me, if I had something to sell, I think I'd hire this guy as a salesman. Who would refuse him? I wouldn't, for good as sake.
I've got something for you.
Well, right after the show, Vern. something you want to try to sell me, huh?
No.
I'll buy you.
Something to give you. Something the Los Angeles higher-ups sent to UCLA to get a Dr. Peter Hassenpfeffer to work a pill up for you.
A growing pill?
A tall pill, yes, yeah. And it's right here in this container.
Oh, thank you very much. Take one, grow tall, guaranteed to make you 6'2" or your money back.
Yes.
Good deal. And this is the pill.
He also makes smart pills.
He makes smart pills, and you took some of those, I'll bet.
Yeah, before that.
Do I have to take this whole thing? I mean, I can't get it.
No, there's one pill in it.
Oh, there's one in it?
Yes, he only had time to make one pill. So you take that one. It's pretty pink and blue.
It is. It's pink and blue, and that'll make me 6'2".
Mm-hmm.
Or 6 foot also, or 6'2"?
6'2".
6 foot, that's about... I can't get rid of it now. There we are. And asking in all the talking we've done with you, Vern, I haven't established the fact of whether or not you are married.
Yes, I am married to a very lovely wife who is in the audience tonight for the first time, by the way.
She's sitting down, but she looks like she might be a fairly tall girl. Did you meet her in the higher-ups?
Yes, I met her in the Los Angeles higher-ups.
She going to stand up?
I don't know.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Do you have children, Vern?
I have one on the way, Jack.
Oh, really? When are you expecting? Or when is your wife expecting?
July the 27th.
Well, good. That's great. In July, you're starting your family then. Vern, let's go over here and start you off on your game. See if you can win your second key. Want to go over to home base with me?
Anywhere.
All right, fine. If you haven't been watching the show, we have quite a major prize for this fellow here. He's a sports enthusiast, especially when it comes to water. He likes anything to do with water, and especially fishing. So we have for Vern a complete fishing outfit carefully selected from the New York Hardware Trading Company, Fisherman's Headquarters, for 50 years in downtown Los Angeles. Everything in the finest of fishing tackle, and with their expert guidance, here's what we've chosen for Vern. First, a complete assortment of fishing lures, spinners, plugs, spoons, flies, and hooks for every possible kind of fishing. Next, we have an assortment of the finest quality fishing rods, including a fly rod, spinning rod, spin cast rod, and a saltwater casting rod. And now, an assortment of exceptionally fine reels to go with those new fishing rods, including a spin cast reel, a spin reel, saltwater reel, and a fly reel, and an assortment of the best fishing lines for each type of fishing. And there is still more, Vern. For your freshwater expeditions, we have this split willow leather-bound creel and net, and for exciting river and trout stream fishing, a pair of quality hood, rubberized cloth hip boots with pleated soles. And to complete the outfit so you can enjoy delightful lunches on your fishing trips, we have this complete fisherman's picnic kit with a deluxe picnic basket. Oh, and we have one other very important item no fisherman should be without. Here it is. Vern is going to also try to win his own speedboat. Take a look at this.
Yes, for your complete fishing outfit and for hours of pleasure on the water, this deluxe Larson Thunderhawk 16, fully equipped with sport steering wheel, comfortable seat cushions, rear running lights, and a 25-horsepower Scott outboard motor, for hours of trouble, free speeding, cruising, and trolling. Yes, it all adds up to a truly complete fishing outfit, a paradise afloat, another green prize from Devin.
Oh, you can say it now. It's all right. Well, Vern, that's your major prize, and believe me, one of our seven keys back here will unlock that door. But right now, we're going to close up the doors and have Colleen come in and put on the lock while we start your game. Now, you know how we play. We give you 15 chances to take the 70 steps to win your second key, and you have penalties and safe zones and bonuses there on the board. We have tough questions, easy questions. It all depends upon the step you land on. Let's see how you work out tonight and what we're going to play.
Jack, I wanted to tell you that the club wants to make you an honorary member. But we didn't get the scroll made up, and so we'll have to wait until next Monday if I'm still here.
If you're still here, well, let's hope you are. You mean an honorary member of the higher-up?
Honorary member of the higher-up.
When I go to the meetings, I'll have to stand on a box or something, won't I? I'll start now. All right, you get me the box to stand on. I'll go to the meetings with you, Vern. Here's your game now. Can you concentrate on this for a minute?
I'll try.
Missing middle initials. Now, we're going to show you world-famous names of people. Matter, Fred, you won't be here Monday night?
Yeah, I'm afraid I won't be here.
We'll show you world-famous names of people who use their middle initial as part of their name. All we want you to do is fill in the missing initial, and when you're set, Vern, hit that one in the middle, and we'll put a one. And let's see what Richard Nixon, his middle initial.
W.
You got it upside down. Richard
M,
yeah. So back we go and start all over. He missed the question. We take him back to the beginning of the row. You didn't have to go too far back. You have 14 chances left. Vern, another step. Three. All right, let's see what's over there. Rutherford Hayes.
I believe that would be a B.
You are right. Rutherford B. Hayes. Okay. 13 left. Let's take another step, Vern. You got a 9 this time. Go to 12 and see what comes up. See if you can get this one now. John Anthony. Did you hear that? Did you hear that come from the audience?
I did hear it.
What'd you hear?
I heard J.
Well, he heard it, and what do you think we ought to do about it? Give it to him because he's on it? All right. So, please, I know you all want to help him, but not so loud. No, whisper. That's not fair. To yourselves. All right, but not loud enough for Vern to hear. All right, let's go. You got a double up there. You're on 12. You have 12 left. Let's take another step.
Okay.
Got a 7. We'll go to 19. Francis Bushman watches this show all the time.
A lot of us know that one. He's a famous actor. X.
Right you are. Francis X. Bushman. All right, now you're moving. Vern, you're on 19. You have 11 chances left. Let's, if you don't mind, we're going
to
earn a couple of bucks here.
I'd love to.
You understand? Okay. We'd like to sneak in this announcement. They will be back to complete Vern's game. Like that. All I did was hold the pill, and I've grown already. I'm going to gain on you before the show's over. All right, let's see where you go this time, Vern. You're on 19 with 11 left, and you got a 10. That's a big one. Let's go to 29. On 29 is Ulysses Grant.
That would be S.
Right it is. Ulysses S. Grant. Okay. 10 more chances. Let's take another step. You got a 7 this time. 7, 7, 14, 15, 16. And we go 36. What do we have there? Dwight.
D for David.
Right you are, Dwight D. Eisenhower. And now he has 9 chances left. Another step. 9. Another big one. 45. From 36 to 45. Scared you there for a minute, didn't we? David Selznick.
I'm not sure, but I think it's David O.
O is right. All right, you're on 45, and now you have 8 left. Let's take another step. This time you got a 6. Let's go to 51. And on 51, you're safe. Okay, don't have to answer a question there. And you have 7 big chances left, Vern. Let's take another step. 3. Let's go to 54 then. Lyndon Johnson.
Well, he's from my home state, Texas. That's Lyndon Bain Johnson.
Everybody in the family's out there. The whole family's LB. All right. 54, what do you have? 6 left? All right, let's have another step. 4. All right, let's go over to 60. See what gives there.
That's better.
58. What, I miscalled it? I'm sorry. 58. I was concentrating on something else here. Thomas Edison.
I think that would be Hal Alvin. A.
For Alva. A-L-V-A. All right, 58, and you have five left, and let's see if I can get this one right. Make it an even number. Oh, you didn't. 67, right? All right, let's go over to 67 and see what we got.
Oh.
What was it? Around with me, boy. I'm going to give you half that pill back. Well, you have to back up, I'm afraid, Vern. Let's hope you don't have to go too far, though. Penalty button. Good. It's a small one. Four. Let's see what's on. That's not bad. Edward Murrow. Well,
I believe that would be Edward R. Murrow.
Right, you are. Edward R. Okay, now you can end it all. You have four chances. You can end it all here if you get a seven or anything over a seven. You've won your second key. He got it. Tonight. Let's get down to business.
There we go.
Here's your decision now. Vern, as you know, you've won two keys. Congratulations. Let me remind you, first of all, that each and every one of the seven keys back here fits the locks on one of our seven prizes. They fit those six prizes across the stage, and, of course, the big one that you're trying for, all that fishing equipment and that beautiful speedboat. All right, you've won two keys. That means if you stop now with the two, Vern, you are sure of winning two valuable prizes, and one of them may be all the fishing equipment in the boat, if you're real lucky. Either way, if you stop now, you can't lose. You know you're going to take home two prizes. However, instead of stopping, you have the option to go on if you want to. You can come back on Monday and try for key number three. But if in trying for three you lose everything. All the keys, all the prizes and everything. We send you home with a small consolation gift. So it's up to you. You want to take the two and stop. You want to come back Monday and try for three. You make up your own mind. What does she want you to do? Now he's going over and take another look at the boat and all the stuff. You can increase your chances of winning it. What do you think?
I think, Jack, due to circumstances beyond my control, greed, I'm going to come back.
Going to come back? All right. Try for three. Very good. Have a nice weekend. Okay. So he'll be back Monday night to try for his big prize. Now, in just a moment, we're going to have the drawing for that fabulous prize, Wonderland, the Fox Stolen, the $500, right after this announcement.